morning, everyone. For this part of for this activity, I have with me a couple of our peer leaders in and I'm developing the instrument themselves. So we thought that it would be a great idea to kind of demonstrate how people experience feedback so that we can learn and grow ourselves, and we learn from others, and from the experience itself. So before we begin, I'm just going to give the mic so that we can
talk. Hello, I'm Amalia Wilson.
Hi, I'm Dad Gaetan, and I am a grad student at the Graduate Center, and I also work with Sylvia and Title Pi. And today we thought we would share with you some of the work we've been doing with peer leaders in the different classrooms in Postal's College. We actually geared this towards them, so it might not be as fitting for all of you, but I know we always give and receive feedback on a daily basis, whether it's from faculty to students, or to staff, and I think it's something we should always be working on. And today we have two scenarios of giving and receiving feedback, and the scenario is based on some activities that the peer leaders do throughout the semester, where they go to each other's tutoring sessions, observe each other, and then give feedback at the end of it. And so in this scenario, I am a peer leader who's finished my session with students. And Amalia is going to be giving me feedback based on my performance.
Enjoy the show. So Dag, I see that you were reviewing a handout that was getting your class ready for the next test. How do you think that went?
I think it went really well. The students were engaged, and I think we covered all the material necessary. And I'm really hopeful they're going to do well on their exam.
Okay, well, I'm sure that you're relieved that I have some feedback for you.
Yeah.
Well, first, I noticed you missed the first part of the handout you were supposed to cover. Then I noticed you were lacking confidence when you were reviewing the second part of the handout. It seemed like you were rushing just to get through that part or to get throughout the entire material, which gave me the feeling that you weren't really ready to review everything.
Well, I didn't think it went as bad. I actually skipped the first part because we covered it in previous sessions, so I didn't want to take too much time out of it. But thank you for the feedback.
Interesting. Do you know what you should work on?
What?
You should work on your confidence. The more confident you are, the more confident your students will be in your ability to teach them.
Okay.
Just look at it on the bright side, Dag. You always have next time to be better.
Thank you. So we have basically the same scenario played out by different actors. This time our wonderful peer leaders, Christina and Abdul, are going to play out the same scenario in hopefully a slightly better way.
Thank you. Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning, Christina. How are you doing today?
I'm good, thank you. How are you?
Thank you for allowing me to observe you. And I've noticed that you were reviewing something that was related to preparing a student to take an exam next week. How do you think it went?
Pretty good. I felt that the students were really engaged with the material, and I think that they're going to do good on the test based on today's review.
Right. I've noticed the same thing too. I'm really happy that you came up, and I really noticed that the student was really engaged, and you took everyone. You also give them motivate everyone, and you know, I feel really like the class is really, you you guys are using this. And I'm really, you know, I learned a lot in during the session. And yeah, you did a great job. I've also noticed that you skip one part of the session plan.
Oh no, I cover it on the last session, so I didn't want to waste time.
Oh, okay, thank you for clarifying. And do you? I also noticed that you actually went a little bit fast, and I would suggest you take it a little bit slower.
Yes, you're right. I will try to work on that.
So yeah, thank you. Is there anything you want to go over in terms of techniques?
Yes, actually, I've been having trouble closing sections, and your help will be great.
Okay, cool. So then let's work on that and see how it
goes. Okay, that will be great.
So as we move forward in the beginning of the semester and just in the semester in general, we want to consider how we give and receive feedback, and we hope that we can continue this conversation, you know, throughout the semester. Some of the things to think about is not just what we're saying, but also how we say it, our tone, our body language, and really what the intention of giving the feedback is. So thank you so much for having us, and thank you so much for your attention.